I just love the Andamans, the scenery, the wildlife, but end of the day, we come here for the fishing. And this trip is going to be one special trip. We're going exploring, pushing further than we've gone before.
You know, you're going to be fishing for fish that attack a lure on the surface with such ferocity, the water explodes, and the next thing that follows is that rod will be wrenched out of your hand and it will take your breath away. It is quite sensational when it happens, and to me that's the essence of this kind of fishing.
So this is the first time I've ever been to the Andaman Islands. It's amazing. I didn't even know they existed, to be perfectly honest, and all of a sudden I find myself here. And the things I've come over for is to catch the giant trevallies, the bluefin tuna, or even yellowfin tuna, yeah, and dogtooth tuna. Yeah.
I've been to the south, and I've been on a couple of exploratory trips that they did over here, and it turned on to be like amazing. You know, if we time it perfectly with tide and, you know, moon phase, stuff like that, it's great.
It's a bit crazy!
Go there!
Go,
over there!
This is mayhem here. Yeah!
Oh, yes!
Gee whiz! Oh my word! I'm going to get this back because we've got some big fish around here. At all.
And I've got an emperor fish, and what a stunning fish.
This is really a big rosy.
Oh no! They have speed, and above all else, they've got stamina. Stamina to burn.
Three, two, one, go!
Oh, unbelievable the run this GT did. 35 kilo.
It's one of my favorite fish after the GT.
Look at me. Oh, I could feel him kicking.
This is our third trip to the beautiful Andaman Islands. They are situated between India and Thailand in the Bay of Bengal. In this trip, we are going to push further than we've ever gone before, hopefully in search of some monster GT and dogtooth tuna. Our expedition begins in Port Blair. We're heading east, out to explore the waters around the invisible bank. We're then going to head back south, past some familiar fishing grounds, and then off to explore the very remote South Central Island. It's the first day of our expedition, and we're all fired up. We've been looking forward to this trip for a very long time. The boat's been packed, and we're heading out to the invisible bank. We're planning to spend a couple of nights out on the boat.
Going today?
Today we're going very, very special place in Andaman. We're going Invisible Bank.
Wow.
That's an amazing spot in the middle of this Andaman Sea. And I cross my finger, maybe on the way, maybe we can meet the yellowfin tuna, because actually you have a nice oceanic current. And yeah, I hope we can have great action.
If we could find the dolphins, we could find the tuna.
Dolphins. See the dolphins, Paul? Dolphins. Beautiful dolphins. Here they come. Yay! Oh, amazing. Oh! It's a bit crazy.
Oh, then dolphins. Yeah.
I'm not going to hook a dolphin, am I?
Oh, it's chasing you.
I know. Gee whiz, look at the size of it. Oh my God.
Oh, outside, outside. Bird outside. Wait. The birds are outside. A lot of birds. Look on the water.
Oh, yes.
Go there.
Bird.
Go. Over there.
This is mayhem here.
Bob, if you got one, I'll go to you, right?
Yeah.
Cast.
They went away. Cast?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, go on, I've got a big one, fella! Yeah! Yeah! Jesus!
Don't flank.
This is a good one. Can I come down there? Checking his head now.
Yeah, baby!
Yeah! Here we go. Yellowfin tuna on the Andamans. What a way to fish. You've got dolphins and then the tuna are nearby. Here we are. Look at this for a creature. Perhaps.
Yeah, I know.
Hey! There we go.
Okay, I'm ready to put the gap in the mouth.
Go back. You got it?
Yeah. Open the bell, please.
You got it?
Yeah, in the mouth.
I'm going to pull this one back if we can. Cheers! Okay, just grab me rod. Yeah, quick picture. I'll move that. we go, the hunt is on. I can't believe how many fish are in here. They must be hammering. Oh, tuna! Tuna! Nice one, Paul. Big one. Wow, here they are again. We're in there.
Fantastic first fish out of the Andamans. Hell of a tuna.
Yes! Yes! Gee whiz!
The explosion on this fish was just insane!
God, yeah, it's amazing. It's a 50, 60 kilo fish. Oh, this looks pulling.
Don't touch it!
Okay, take the load out. Release.
We decided to keep just one tuna for the table for later. Mr. Broadhurst couldn't wait though, and was soon tucking in.
He doesn't get any fresh in this. Straight off the fish, straight out the sea. Fantastic. Absolutely fantastic.
After a couple of hours motoring, we were soon at the amazing invisible bank. It's a large flat plateau that rises from the depths. The waters surrounding the invisible bank go down to depths as far as 2,000 metres. It wasn't long until we were connected to some of the local residents. Nico then hit the jackpot with a massive topwater doggy.
Gee whiz, that's a proper one. Just bagged
it! Merci, ça m'a fait donner la chance.
You should make some mistake right off.
Wow!
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. GTs around the bank just didn't want to play ball, but we'd still had an absolutely fantastic day. The following morning, we were up early and were greeted by the most beautiful sunrise. Expectations were high, but it soon became apparent that the GTs just didn't want to play ball. They had no interest in hitting our surface poppers at all. The decision was made to go and search some of the deeper marks. Hopefully, this would produce the goods. Nico's hunch was correct, and we were soon into some great jigging action.
Oh, we're in again, we're on a good mark here.
That is jigging.
For the jigging. We're having multiple hookups. Santi's got
some
one.
Nice mark, Sammy, and jig to 20 meters, bottom to 20 meters. Fish come fucking.
It's not the fucking fish. Small GT.
Slowly, yeah, bubbles come up.
Yeah. Oh, that's a nice job, fish. Whoa! Look at that. Small GT.
Yeah.
Let's get this one back. And we got a job fish as well. What a pair. We're on a mark here. And beauties. That's a good sized job fish. Is that a green job fish?
Yeah, yeah. Green job fish.
Good. Green job fish. Right.
Release.
Let's get them in. Here we go. 1, 2, 3.
It's good, huh?
Soon as we dropped the jigs, you were straight into action.
We're in again. Double hook up. This is some of the best jigging we've had. We've been getting some emperor fish and GTs. We've got no idea what we've got on here. What do you think, Bob?
I'm not sure. It could be a bigger GT. A small dog.
What the hell are
that? I really don't know, Bob.
Oh, I've got an emperor.
Same fish.
Yeah, I'm just going to let it.
Same as you, anyway.
Cracking fighting fish. There's nothing back home in England fights like this. Nothing at all.
And I've got an emperor fish, and what a stunning fish. So let's get them back.
Yeah. We'll look at the lips on that, though, with the yellow and the teeth.
Go.
Yeah. It was only a matter of time before something big got in on the act.
Come on! Stop!
On the Saragossa, right?
Yeah! Good luck now.
No. You look like you're pulling Stuart off your wife.
Yes. What is it?
Sometimes it's not come in up.
This was clearly a big fish.
Slowly, Arjun, if he can't come, he can't come.
If he can't come, you go.
Yeah. After 30 minutes in, Arjun was feeling the pain.
Sounding deep.
What is it?
It's big.
Shark.
I don't know.
Or huge doggy.
But where is your line?
So, we've now got Banty stepped into the breach because obviously Arj is a bit of a pussy and he's broke out in the sweat. Now we want a man on the job. Come on, Banty. You can get this one too. Kind of fishing is pretty big.
Oh,
and it's broken.
Shark, let me see.
No, it looks like we've got a bite off here.
We were gutted not to see that fish, but on the next drop down, Bob was in again, so it was soon all forgotten.
We just dropped on a new mark here. It's 90 metres deep. And I've gone in with a 200 gram jig, and on my first raise, I've hit something big. What's the GT?
No, it's not, it's a big dogfish.
Oh, hold on, my line.
Is it?
Amberjack.
Amberjack. Ooh.
No,
jumpfish.
Jumpfish, you jump.
Oh my god.
Net.
Whoa, look at that. Oh, let's get in there.
You're a big jumpfish.
That's a big jumpfish.
Wait, 70 meters.
Yeah!
That's it! Again.
Whoa.
That's a proper jumpfish.
This is a fantastic jumpfish.
Go over there.
Really?
Hang on.
Sorry,
guys.
Okay, I'm going to get this back because we've got some big fish around here. That's just a fantastic.
No, Bunty, don't approach. Okay.
GT's just been caught.
Don't move, yes.
Let's have this back.
Okay.
Whilst moving between marks, we came across a group of beautiful pilot whales. These normally shy creatures were suddenly taking an interest in our boat.
You should put the GoPro.
This was such a privilege to see.
Put my GoPro and put it.
What happened next, though, was one of the most amazing sights I have ever seen on my angling travels.
Put it.
The whales stopped next to us and then started to bob up and down just to have a look at us.
Oh, they're curious to know what's going on. Keep doing what you're doing.
We couldn't believe what we'd just witnessed, and with that, they were off. We were soon back into some great jigging action.
Again. Is in.
Four.
On the hook.
Yes.
That's deep. You see the size of those pectorals there.
After a good night's sleep at the guest house, we were soon heading out once again, this time to South Sentinel. As the monsoon season was approaching, we were greeted with some heavy downpours. It's a long way to South Sentinel, 4 hours in total. Nico told us on the way we were going to fish one of my favourite spots, the wall.
Ready to drop?
It's basically a cliff face which drops down to 90 metres. Speed jigging was the order of the day, and on my third drop, all hell broke loose. Would we get to see this fish? Only time would tell.
Oh dear. Just let it go. Well, something's taken me bait. It's obviously of considerable size. I'm running out of line, guys. Could it be a dog? Could it be a big dog? Could it be a big dog tooth? Huge. It's a big fish. We think it might be a shark, but you never know out here. It could be anything. I just hope we get a chance to see this. It looks horrible and rainy, but I can tell you it's lovely and warm. I can see colour. Let's see. Oh my word, it's something big. Something big. Whoa, look at the size of that for a GT. Whoa. My word! How big's that? No way! Oh my word! That is a proper... Oh yeah! Gee whiz!
What was this for the sound?
Yes.
120.
Oh, I think about it.
120. It's a beautiful fish.
Oh, unbelievable the run this GT did. 35 kilo. Yeah. Awesome GT.
Look at me. Be proud of the catch.
After catching that big GT, the next 2 hours flew by. South Sentinel was soon on the horizon.
Good fish, Bob. Bob, you can see fish.
We were going to try some surface poppers to see if we could raise some GTs from the surrounding reefs. The terrain looks so good for some GT action. South Sentinel was such a beautiful place, but once again the GTs were playing hard to get, so I decided to put a stick bait on to see if that could induce a take. I'd spotted a small bait ball and decided to cast my stick bait just to the left of it.
Fish around there.
Yeah!
Well done.
Come down.
Can we walk back, Bob?
Okay, reel now. Reel and bump. Okay,
just come back. Jesus. Just on edge of that bait ball, wasn't it? Jesus Christ. This is South Sentinel for you. What a place. Let's put a stick bait on. And it absolutely nailed it.
For the line, don't touch.
Yeah. Oh, we just arrived at the South Sentinel. We've only been here 10 minutes. And we just hooked into a nice GT, I think. Crazy, typical, brutal attack. We're just going to move the boat. It's the backdrop though, isn't it? Oh, that's a nice one. I'll take that. That'll do. Hat off, glasses off. Okay?
Yeah.
Sorry, that's fucking heavy.
I want to do the release whenever you're ready. You tell me.
Yeah, I'm ready, Bobby. You ready? Right, here we go. We're going to put it back. 3, 2, 1, go!
We have a day and a half
here. Can we do one
with no more action at the north side, we decided to move to the south side of the island. This was such a remote location. All we could hear were the crashing waves on the shore.
Okay guys, tomorrow I change my driver. Tomorrow is calling
day. It wasn't long before we'd found some more bait balls, and hopefully the GT would be nearby. Over the next 5 minutes, we were reminded what GT fishing is all about.
Yes! Yes, it was. Perfect top water action. Come here, old Papa.
Come on, Bob.
I'm here. Suddenly I'm energised.
Oh.
I think Sammy's into one as well. Oh, and Paul's in! What? Yes.
That's a proper fucking fish.
Go back.
Treble hook up!
Bob, go behind.
Ooh, yes. This is pulling properly.
Wait.
Whoa. Oh, sorry.
It's okay. Oh. This is sensational action. Get him up. This is taking me right around the boat. It's no wonder the giant trevally has become a cult fish. Not only do they have strength, they have speed, and above all else, they've got stamina. Stamina to burn. They don't never give up till they're in the boat. And thankfully, when they are in the boat, they behave like pussycats. Oh no! Oh no! Hook's falling out. Oh no, that is just unfair. Yeah.
Open our bell, open our bell.
Oh, right, yeah. I'm going to stay back in the gaff now. Feeling fish.
Make it lighter, huh? Yeah. Ask you in one.
Thank it.
Okay? Ça va?
Yeah.
Fantastic bit of sport there. This thing's drunting away from my first double figure GT in the Andamans. Let's get him back.
Over our last couple of days, the fishing got harder, mainly down to some ocean currents. At times, we still had some amazing action. The Andamans had left its mark, and we knew we would return.
This is really a big rosy act. You know, I've caught so many rosy, I've never caught one like that.
You can see the mouth and the big teeth of that fish, so aggressive, and you have a very, very good fight. This is very nice.